Welcome back, rebellious generals. This is Gaines's Mill in the Confederate campaign. I'm Major General Difficulty in version 1.28.4 of the J&P Mod. The battle was mostly successful, though I would have liked to get some more captures. I did have a huge number of promotions, including getting my first couple of Major Generals. First, thank you for taking the time to check out any of my materials related to the game. I hope that you find something to help you achieve success in your own campaigns. Do not hesitate to ask questions in the comments. Be aware that Colonel, Brigadier General, and Major General difficulties all share an AI profile. Legendary has its own profile. Therefore, things that you see me do should easily translate to lower difficulties but may not work in Legendary or be suboptimal. When we last left our heroes, they had a pretty easy victory at First Winchester. Going into camp before Gaines's Mill, my entire army was 19 units. 9 infantry, 4 artillery, 3 cav, and 3 dedicated skirmishers. I will now be expanding to 39 units for Gaines's Mill, so just over doubling in size. That means a bunch of rookies with crap stats. As always, it's important to understand how the army deploys before the battle. Gaines's Mill has 3 phases. We will start the battle with the 1st and 2nd divisions of 1st Corps. At the start of Phase 2, we immediately get the 3rd Division from 1st Corps. About 10 minutes into Phase 2, we get the 1st Division from 2nd Corps. And then with about 55 minutes in Phase 2, we get the 1st and 2nd Divisions of 3rd Corps. This is the intended flanking force that comes in from the upper right side of the screen. With about an hour and 45 minutes left in Phase 3, 4th Division of 1st Corps appears from the upper left. D.H. Hill has 1st Corps, and he should hit Major General in this battle. Beauregard has 1st Division, which includes Siegfried, Kemper, Forrest, Cabell, and Caldwell. Ransom has 2nd Division, which includes Jackson, Pugh, Wilcox, Leggett, and Roberts. Mercy commands 3rd Division, which has 5 rookie units, Root, Andrews, Wheeler, Kitching, and Gibson. Rhodes has 4th Division with 5 rookie skirmishers, Bryan, Mason, Weisinger, Miles, and York. Johnston has 2nd Corps and should also make Major General here. Preston has the only division here, which is our 4 cav units, Hobson, Owen, Rowett, and Hazen. My Avatar has 3rd Corps and likely will hit Major General at Malvern. Ferrero has 1st Division, which includes Latimer, Thoburn, Roberts, Brooke, and Peabody. Breckenridge has 2nd Division with McNair, Rice, Hood, Nicholas, and Scribner. Kershaw has 3rd Division filled with rookie units, Miles, Darden, Baldwin, McCord, and Swallow. My career point from 1st Winchester went into politics to finish that off. With the shop about to reset after Gaines's, I went ahead and bought up some skirmisher and cav weapons. I bought heavy guns, but since I need to be mobile at this battle, I purposely didn't bring any to this fight. Napoleons and the 12-pound howitzers will move faster to help keep up with my assault force. All 3 supply wagons are maxed out at 30,000. I took the 53 Enfields, Beauregard, and Kershaw with reputation points. I wouldn't fault you if you took either of the Whitworths here. It just depends on what you want to do. The AI got another 20,000 recruits after First Winchester, and we're off to the battle. The AI will have 36,875 men and 94 guns. With 20% splits after the battle starts, it'll be a bit more than that. I'm bringing 34,367 and 50 guns. The battle has 3 phases. I will feign an attack from the center while maneuvering troops to link up with my flanking force. In my experience, the AI is more effective when it can focus its forces in one area and try to steamroll the player. Therefore, I prefer to start a feign to get its attention while setting up attacks from one or more other directions. The AI will have its skirmishers out to begin the first phase, so they're the first obstacle. They will be a combination of dedicated and detached skirmishers. As I said, I start the battle with my 1st and 2nd Divisions of 1st Corps. I'll lead with my skirmishers to try and reveal where the AI units are located. The AI only has a few dedicated skirmisher units, so with a little luck, I can eliminate most of them right at the start. It's tempting to charge after them immediately, but the AI has more units in cover behind those that we can see, so I need to be patient.
Thank you.
I'll move my detached forward to try and find these guys. The AI unit's wavering and moving into the water is always a good thing. There's another skirmisher. I knew these guys weren't out here alone. There should be three or four detached skirmishers near the river too. I believe the AI would prefer I pursue his units across the river to the south. I'd end up fighting out in the open against his units that are in the fortifications. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to stay towards the north and center area and try to make the AI come out to me. If the path is clear, I'll try to take the supply wagon, but I'm not going to sacrifice my calf for it. I don't see any additional dots on the mini-map, so I'm going to try it. There's his support. Push the skirmishers back to their line. I have no interest in moving up to the fortifications. My skirmishers will hang out in the wood line while my infantry moves towards the center of the battlefield. Jackson, Pugh, and Wilcox will set up a defensive line along with some of the skirmishers and Cabell's artillery. Kemper, Siegfried, and Forrest will keep moving to the right to link up with my flanking force. I want the AI to engage my forces defending the center, but not with an overwhelming force. I just want it to split its forces so my flanking force has less to fight all at once. Keep in mind, if the AI rolls some good heavy-duty artillery in this battle, my center defense can start taking a pounding, so I need to pay attention to how much damage they start taking. The AI will often move three or four batteries around the northern VP to start shelling my guys when they're set up here. I'll pull Jackson back a minute to force the AI to target someone else. Most of my other forces here are still hidden from view. There's just a lot of moving and getting into position in these early hours. Attacking the fortifications from the left side is just a bad idea, and even if you could do it easily, it's slow moving through the swampy area. We get 3rd Division as soon as Phase 2 starts. The 1st Division of 2nd Corps will arrive in a few minutes. I will start to position units on the far right to scout ahead and get a feel for how the AI is positioning its troops. Most of my 1st Division and 2nd Corps are KEV and fast-moving units to get into position quickly. My 3rd Corps will arrive with about 55 minutes left in this phase, so I have about an hour before the heavy action actually starts.
Thank you.
It appears the AI is pulling some units from its right flank to move towards the center. We'll see what it does with them. I really only want to leave a division at the center, but if the AI gets aggressive, I may have to rethink that. AI cav could be devastating, but it rarely deploys them effectively. I need to pull some units down to intercept all the troops the AI is shifting to the center, and that's not a bad thing. Kemper and Siegfried will get into the action earlier than I expected. We'll see how this goes. Thank you. And just like that, officers are dropping left and right. Captured one skirmisher and I routed the cav. Things could have gone worse, I suppose. These units moving north almost seem to have a pre-designated area that they're heading to. Not like they were just coming to attack, but maybe they intended to move north and ambush my flank attack or something. The No-Star infantry units are arriving at the center, so I'll place them and fall back a bit with my better units. His cav unit is back to heroic and wants to make a run at some of my skirmishers again. His cav are routing and isolated, so I'll see if I can eliminate him. All right, the cav unit is gone. I'm not sure if he has another one or not. The AI infantry seems to be rerouting. Evidently, its GPS says that it can't get through that way. The Third Corps flanking units are arriving. Once they get into place, it'll be a continuous fight until the end. I won't get any additional reinforcements until Phase 3 starts. With 2 hours in Phase 3 and 55 minutes here, I have just under 3 hours to capture the VPs and maximize AI casualties. pushed my detached skirmishers in the woods to scout ahead for the infantry. My cav will move down farther south. Hopefully I can get my guys into cover quickly.
Thank you.
AI units are headed this way, but there is little resistance so far. I want my skirmishers to keep the infantry busy and let my cav get some of the shots on the artillery. Taking McGee Hill shouldn't be much of a problem. Alright, this is the last phase. I have 2 hours to make it happen. Right now, I need to take out 2 artillery batteries, then 3 or 4 infantry brigades, then I can flank the fortifications and start rolling them up from right to left. Taking the VP might cause the AI to shift a bunch of forces to the right, but we'll see. When my reinforcements come in, I'll have them start attacking on the far left to force the AI to keep units over there.
Yeah!
His infantry is going for the supply wagon, so this might be fun. I'll fade some of my cav back to let the infantry isolate itself. Okay, he stopped running, so I'll attack with my cav. These charging AI units are just helping me take them out faster. The Union right flank is in full collapse now. Still, I'm not sure how many I can take out before the end. I don't want to sacrifice my skirmishers. I just want to keep the AI honest and pin down these 3,000 man units so they don't come to the right side. He's charging over here. I wasn't expecting that. Hopefully he'll burn up his condition and lose morale and my guys can take him. At this point, I just want to avoid losing too many officers. All my artillery is pulled up, so I'll let them and my skirmishers work to push these guys off the VP. Here comes a two-star charging north. I don't have much immediate support here either. We have the second VP, although I doubt that I can clear all the AI units off the field with the time remaining. Thank you. Most of these guys have just enough cover to prevent me from pushing them any faster. I wish all the remaining AI forces would charge and allow me to shatter or capture more of them. Seven minutes left and Forrest goes down. That's not helping. How many units that one infantry just routed? You wouldn't think that would be possible. We got the victory. I had 1,853 men killed, 4,982 wounded, and 820 missing, for a total of 7,657 casualties. The AI had 15,666 casualties and 2,078 captured. The usual suspects are at the top of the kill sheet. I got a bunch of promotions. Wilcox and Cabell made general, and Hill and Johnston both made it to major general. That wraps up Gaines' Mill for the CSA. Thank you so much for spending some of your valuable time watching today. I hope you found something useful for your campaigns, and I wish you much success, generals.